What's up ghouls, it's Blaze and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm filming for you a makeup tutorial as I haven't done one in a while. So I'm filming this green cut crease type thing that you can see. It's a basic cut crease, there's no glitter, no super crazy, I don't know, no crazy eyeliner, nothing like that. It's a pretty simple look because A, I've been pretty rushed for time, I'm supposed to be meeting my friend soon, and B, I'm still practicing and didn't want to attempt anything too crazy. So yeah, I just want to apologise for the noise in the video. It's been pretty noisy outside, the storm has just finished. Pumpkin has been noisy as ever, tried to protect my brushes several times and kept pulling my top down, so I'm so sorry about Pumpkin's savage behaviour. I don't really know what else to say in this intro other than if you're enjoying the content, please subscribe, please like and comment because I love interacting with you guys. And also don't forget, I'll be filming my Q&A, so if you have any questions then follow the link in the description box and I will post it here too so that I can answer some of your questions because that would be really fun. Yeah, so on with the tutorial. I'm going to, Pumpkin's in the video, hello Pumpkin. I'm going to begin the look with Soap & Glory's Bright & Pearly Radiance Boosting Cocktail. This is a new product, I saw it in store and it was, it was buy one get one half price and I needed a new... What are you doing? There you go, you can see now. It was buy one get one half price. I needed a new moisturiser and I wanted to repurchase the one I had last time. So I decided, because my moisturiser is £13 and this was £14 and I wanted to try it so I could get both for like £20 instead of just buying one. So I did that. I think I saved like £7, so that's pretty good. Or £6, I don't know. One of the two. Yeah, shut up. So I do like this product. I think it smells amazing. It makes my skin really soft, ready for applying all my other rubbish that goes on my face. I'm not entirely sure whether it brightens my skin, but I do like it. I like the smell. It means I have to use less moisturizer, so that's good. Yeah, I would say it's a pretty good product. I'm then going in with my Speed Plump All Day Super Moisture Marvel Soap & Glory Moisturizer. This is still my old one. I am being so, I don't know the word, cheap. I am using every last, little drop from this because, like I said, it's £13, which to me for a moisturiser is kind of expensive, so I'm trying to be as good as possible. I love the ring light because it makes it look like I have nice skin. I do. Right. I'm then gonna go in with my Kat Von D Hydrating Featherweight Primer and Base, like normal. Passing that into my skin, making sure I've completely covered everywhere because otherwise if I don't use this, then my foundation just clings to my dry patches and it's not good. Then I'm going in with my NYX Pore Filler Primer. I always use the two together because I have dry skin and pores, so it's pretty good. The Kat Von D Primer is really good for dry skin, but I wouldn't say it's that good for like covering, oh my goodness, for covering texture and things like that, so that's why I need both. Best of both worlds. I always pay extra attention with this primer to my nose and my cheeks because that is where I seem to get the most texture from a foundation. I forgot to wear my beauty blender. Next I'm going to apply Kat Von D's Look It Foundation in L42. I don't know if I've said this before, but when this was first available in the UK, this was the lightest shade, L42. And then I was watching a live video of, goodness, what's her name? I freaking love her. How can I not remember? Gulrot. Gulrot on Instagram. Again, I'll link her below. I literally like just pick up at least one person's Instagram every video. I was watching a live of hers, and her makeup looked so good, and her foundation looked so fucking pale. And I was like, what foundation are you using? And she was like, oh, Kat Von D. And I was like, what's the shade? She was like, L41. I was like, what? There's lighter? So it was available in America and not here, but now it's available here. So I'm almost out of this foundation. So when I'm out, I'm definitely gonna get L41. And I'm very excited. It's gonna be so good because like this does match my skin tone. It's maybe in terms of like normal person, it's maybe a shade or two light, but I love light foundation. So the lighter the better. So I am gonna try L41. Poppy's been so naughty at the moment. She just woke up from a nap, so she's been very stressful. She's been so like crazy all morning, like I couldn't sit on the sofa because she was just like trying to chew my hair, trying to chew my face. She scratched up my legs while I was eating my breakfast at the breakfast bar. So I was like, right, you know what, I'm just gonna go and chill in my bedroom, stay away, give you time to be crazy. So I did, and then after a while like a storm started outside, so I was like, oh, she must be scared. So I came in and got her, brought her into my bedroom. Kat Von D's Locket Concealer Cream in white out. Yeah, so I brought her into my bedroom, brought her on the bed for me, and then she was so good, and she fell asleep on my lap, and it was so cute, and she was so nice. And then I was like, oh shit, I need to get ready. So then I had to wake her up, and now she's crazy again. But yeah, originally I was just gonna stay in all day, I had no plans. I was like, I know I need to film, but I don't know what to film, and I have like 5 days off in a row now, well after today I have 4, so I was like, I have plenty of time to film videos, so I'm not gonna like force myself to film a video today if I can't think of anything. So I just left it, and then my friend Katie texted and said she's out with her girlfriend at the moment, and did I want to hang out after her girlfriend goes to work. So I was like, yeah, and I haven't seen Katie in so long, so I'm going to go and hang out. So I thought I'd film a get ready with me. So yeah, that is why I'm here right now, filming. I'm now taking my Kryolan translucent powder and setting that concealer and then my foundation with my Beauty Blender. Cool. Pumpkin just appeared behind me. Oh my goodness, that scared the hell out of me. I did have the e.l.f. HD high definition, whatever, translucent powder, and it's good because it's really light, and it does make your skin look lighter when you apply it. However, it really showed up the dry patches on my skin, and I feel like it dried out my skin more. And I did include it in my favorites video because I did really like it, but now I use Kryolan if my skin is particularly dry, like it is at the moment. I think she's about to start teething, and I'm really not looking forward to that. Like literally like 2 days after I got her, my friend Phoebe was like, wait till they start teething, and I was like, oh my god, what? And now I'm like, she's teething. I'm snacking while I'm filming. I'm eating a Sainsbury's chocolate and orange bar, but it's like the free from one, so it's vegan. Holy fuck, it's so good, and it's only 40p. I recommend. Right, I'm now going to contour with the shade in my quad in Smoke, using the biggest shade here. This, I'm sure you guys know, is my go-to contour shade. It's so super cool tone. It's so good. Also, a little bit of news. So my dad keeps asking me what I want to do when I finish uni. I don't know if a lot of you know, but I'm studying fashion styling. And I'm enjoying the course, I enjoy the work, however, I don't think I really want to go into the fashion industry as a stylist or anything like that, because, I don't know, I mean, I wouldn't want to be a freelance stylist, I'd have to move to London. I'm really not, I don't have the right personality, I don't think, to want to live in London. I mean, Jake wouldn't mind it, but I personally couldn't do it. I'm gonna start doing my eyebrows now with Freedom's eyebrow pomade in granite and the Real Techniques 202 eyeliner brush. Yeah, so I personally wouldn't want to be a freelance stylist. Basically, any well-paying, good, you know, job in the fashion industry in terms of like styling or creative direction or photographer, like I would have to work in and around London, and I don't want to do that. When I first started uni, I thought maybe I would want to, but the more I'm doing it, the more I've decided it's not for me, it's not like the life that I want at this point in time. So my dad's like, what do you want to do when you finish uni? And I was like, well, as soon as I finish, I mean, I need to get some kind of full-time job so I can pay my bills. So just whatever. And my dad was like, there's no point doing a degree if you're gonna, you know, not get a job in the degree that you've been doing. So I was thinking, and I've been thinking about it for a long time, and I would like to work in a funeral home and prepare the bodies for viewing, so like doing the makeup and stuff, like airbrushing, and I think that would be really, really cool. Would you stop trying to grab my, she's pulling my top down, my goodness. Yeah, I think it would be really cool, I think I'd enjoy it. I'm just such an introvert that like I am not built for a huge industry with loads of people, and I don't know, I feel like it's a lot calmer. Obviously, I mean, you'd be working with dead people, so be a lot calmer. So yeah, so I told my dad, I was like, look, I think that's what I want to do, and he was like, well, I know a guy who's somewhat in the industry, so now he's hooking me up with some work experience. It's not confirmed yet, but that is the aim right now, is he's trying to get me some work experience, so that is pretty cool. So yeah, I will keep you guys updated on that if I manage to get some experience. And my brows done. Time check. I have about half an hour. Okay. Right, so I'm gonna be attempting a cut crease green thing. I'm just gonna wing it. Okay, I'm gonna start off by setting the whole of the eye with a white eyeshadow, and I'm gonna be using Linen from the Metal Matte palette, and then I'm just gonna take like a huge brush and set the whole of the eye. Knocked two of my palettes off the my vanity as I was doing my makeup the other day. She knocked this one, the Metal Matte palette, and the Alchemist palette both at the same time. And I managed to catch the Metal Matte palette, and the Alchemist bounced off of this one and onto the floor, and I was like, if you have just broken that, oh my goodness. But luckily it didn't break, but I would rather that one broke because I can't rebuy this because it's limited edition, but the other one is still available online, so I would have been okay. Not that I have the money to repurchase it, but still. Okay, so I'm going to be using the Urban Decay Full Spectrum palette, and I'm planning to do a look for Pride with this because I'm working the day of Pride, but I want to do some cute makeup, so I think I will probably use this palette. So I'm going to be taking the shade Hatter, which is, I'll show you, this green shade here, and I may also use Mean later on, but it is quite shimmery, so I'm not sure. So I'm going to be using Hatter on the fluffy brush side of the one that comes in the palette, and this is rather pigmented, so I'm going to pat the excess off, and I'm going to just start buffing that into the crease, just giving it a really light wash at first, because you can build up the colour but you cannot take it away. Well, you can cut the crease, but that's different. And I'm going to pull it out slightly too. these top bits, the bit towards my brow, to be more lime green. So I'm gonna go in with the shade Mean and see what happens, because it may be too shimmery. I also feel like I need to point out to you guys that I've mentioned before that on my course we do buy an element of hair and makeup. I mean, we learn how to do a base, we learn how to decide someone's eye shape, we learn how to apply lipstick depending on the lip shape. We literally learned the basics. I never learned anything to do with a cut crease or applying eyeshadow, like, you know, anything fun or interesting. We did not learn a lot because it's not a hair and makeup course. It was just like two modules within. We learned more theory than actual practice. So that is why my looks aren't like incredible, because I'm still learning, I'm teaching myself. I'm going to try to cut the crease now. So I'm taking my Kat Von D Locket Concealer that I used earlier, and I'm taking a really tiny concealer brush, which is a little bit dirty, so I'm hoping it's gonna be okay. And I'm just going to get some on my brush and look straight ahead and go above where my natural crease is. Is kind of even. So now I'm going to cover that whole section in the Locket Concealer. I just mixed together white out and locket, you know, same thing. Of inner corner, just to really accentuate the lines and the crease and to enlarge my eye even more. Okay, so I got some of the green mixed up in the concealer, but I'm going to be covering that anyway. But I'm going to dab a little more on top. Back in with that big brush from the start and pack linen back onto my lid over the top of the white out concealer. Now I'm going to take the smaller end of the brush from the Full Spectrum palette, so it's more dense. So I'm going to go back in with Hatter, the darker shade, and I'm going to follow along the line where we cut the crease to define it. Side again and take the shade Hatter and brush that under my lower lash line. From the liner in Trooper and draw on a wing. I'm going to leave it there in terms of just the eye makeup. I don't want anything too anything too crazy because it's like one of my first attempts, so yeah. And now I'm gonna pop on some mascara. I'm gonna use Too Faced's Better Than Sex. More color, I'm gonna add some more of the shade Mean on my lower lash line just to add a bit more of that lighter lime shade to pull it all together. Yeah, that's better. Now I'm taking Essence's Lash Princess and I'm popping that on my lower lash line as the brush is way smaller and way better for lower lashes. To finish off my green look, I'm going to be taking Jeffree Star's liquid lipstick in Crocodile Tears. I really need to find a new green liquid lipstick. I love this shade, but I just do not support his brand in the slightest, so I don't want to keep using it. You guys will have to link below or let me know of any green liquid lipsticks you know that you could recommend because they are of a reputable brand. I'm gonna pop on some highlighter. This is ColourPop's Flexitarian and I always use my fingers for this. I feel like there is probably a better way, something that's gonna be more, it's gonna make it last longer or stay put or make it shinier, but I feel like because it's a cream it's kind of difficult and it seems to just like not transfer off of my brushes properly. So I don't know, if you guys have any suggestions then again let me know. The look is complete. I'm not super happy with the eyes. I would have liked to add something more to it, but like I said, A, I'm pushed for time, and B, I'm still experimenting and practicing, and I'm really hoping that I can keep practicing and keep trying these looks and then I can grow along with you guys. And yeah, like, I obviously have a long way to go with makeup, but I really enjoy doing it and it's really fun. Okay, so I just changed my outfit. Well, I still have the same top on, but I took my pajama bottoms off and took the weird clips out of my hair. So I'm pretty much ready to go. Yeah, like I said, I'm in a super rush. So I'm really sorry if this video is kind of quick and kind of rushed. I don't know, because again, can't see the time on the screen, but I had fun filming it and I'm definitely going to be filming some more over the next few days because I, like I said, have 4 days off now. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and I'll see you next time. Bye.